Hello friends, welcome to Aculmec Live. I'm Kanchan Verma and today in this episode we'll be discussing about Environment Day. The theme of Environment Day was ecosystem restoration. So are we doing ecosystem restoration in day-to-day life? We'll be discussing this with our guest today. But before that, I would like to remind you there's a free gift available only for you. So stick around to this episode till the end. We'll guide you how to avail your free gift. Hello friends, welcome to the show, and today we are discussing about Environment Day, which we celebrated on 5th of June 2021. Now, it was started in 1973 by United Nations. So the Environment Day means different to different people. So I will be asking to my guest today, Ritu Gupta, to tell us about this and what this day means to her. So welcome to the show, Ritu. How are you doing today?
Thank you, Kanchan. Thank you for inviting me to the show, and I'm absolutely fine. Thank you, and I hope you're also doing fine. And it's a pleasure for me to be invited on your show to discuss a very important topic, which is about environment.
Yeah, lovely. Because, you know, the environment over the period of time become a crucial topic to discuss, because for various reasons, because there is some problem pertaining to environment. It is not being very comfortable when we talk about environment, because there's pollution and all sort of bad things is happening with human life and of course the animal life. So what do you really understand and what do you feel about this Environment Day, and how we can really go forward to improve the environment?
Yeah, I think it's a very nice thing to celebrate Environment Day. And you know what I really, for me, the celebration of Environment Day means to say thank you to the God for giving us such a lovely environment, giving us oxygen that we are breathing and we are alive. But at the same time, in today's present scenario, I feel that Environment Day celebration means that we should make other people aware about how to keep our environment clean and green and not to create mess for the future generation. So this is something which we have got free of cost from the Mother Earth, and we should really preserve it and be grateful for it. This is what I personally mean by Environment Day celebration, and also by planting one tree at least by one family or a person.
Yes, and you know, this year 2021, approximately 143 countries participated to celebrate this Environment Day and this June. Yes. And but lately there's an American research that found the environment is changing every day, and it's changing rapidly. And we also feel that we have to do something about our changing environment. Though the topic of this Environment Day was ecology restoration. Mm. So what you really feel that as a community member we can do to really teach about certain things which can give which can save our environment?
Yes, to save the environment, we need to definitely, I agree that we need to restore the environment. And by restoring the environment means going back to do things which we were doing, and not to, you know, cut down the trees, not to finish the forest, not to do the deforestation. And global warming, you know, the environment is changing. It's because of global warming. The change of environment is there everywhere, not even in bigger cities, but when you go to the rural areas also. And I think it's all over the globe because of our lifestyle, present lifestyle, our habits, and because of so much of population. There's so much of population everywhere, and everyone is creating some kind of garbage. So the creation of this garbage is definitely leading to the change of environment. You see, the glaciers are melting. It's because people have reached everywhere. They're living everywhere. They are doing all kind of commercial activities, which should be stopped. Of course, you have to do commercial activities, but then there are some rules, some norms which have to be followed, and we should not play against the Mother Earth. So as a community member, I feel that anyone who's living in a society, who's living in a community is a social animal, and we at our end, we should create awareness, we should plant trees. And in present pandemic time, since we cannot go out of the house, by staying in the house, we can create a community group on WhatsApp, perhaps send each other text messages also, send out the research paper for other person to read, that what is environment all about, why things are going so bad, so that there is some awareness. And when things become normal, when we are able to go out, so we can do our bit of share, whatever we can, perhaps by planting trees, perhaps, you know, letting people know how to save water also. And as a community member, I feel that personally right now, we should do more of gardening in our house, by, you know, just planting green chilies or the mint leaves or whatever, anything, you know, it's very good for the atmosphere also.
Yes, actually, it is very good point which you have mentioned, especially when this period of time of pandemic and everybody is at home. But there's a positive side of being at home is that river water is being cleaned. People are not visiting riverbanks. The air is clean because there's no vehicle on the road. So air is clean. So this is something which is good, which is happening, though we all are suffering with pandemic because we have restricted movement. Children are not going to school. And that is, I feel personally, is a lack of development when we talk about children. But there's one very negative aspect of this whole, especially pandemic, which has given, is like dumping these PP suits, gloves, masks, and that again is creating a problem for environment. So what you would like to suggest and guide people to really do with whatever they are doing, like dumping and increasing their footfalls in the hospital for small things, and going to giving away surgical masks, throwing it on the road sometimes if they are coming from somewhere. So that is one thing which is, I think, is a negative aspect of current time.
Yes, you know, the positivity, as you said, and I 100% agree, the positive side of this lockdown has been that we are not going out. So you see less of traffic on the roads. So there is no traffic. The air is clean. Since there is no traffic, there is no consumption of fuel also. The air is clean. And we can see birds, clean sky, blue sky. Everything is fine. But the negative part of this pandemic has been that people are wearing PPE suits. They are using so much of plastic in the hospital, which has to be thrown. It's a garbage, it's a one-time use. So, you know, there are ways that you can dispose it of. First of all, the sanitation staff, the kids, even the kids in the house, they should be taught, they should be informed, they should be made aware that these things should not be thrown anywhere. There is a way of dumping out these things, and then they are collected and then further disposed of in various other manners. It's a big process of how to dispose of these things. But then one should be very clear about, you should not be using these things till the time it is really essential. Till the time it is very essential. So I think the development is required right now, the development of the brain, which can happen only by educating people about how to make your environment stay clean without these e-wastages and plastic wastages. Anyway, because we all know that plastic is really spoiling the environment. And because of this plastic, so much of carbon dioxide is being created in the environment, which further is changing the environment, the weather, the climate change is happening because of this. So at the moment, what we can do is make people aware about it, make them know, make them educate about all these things, give out the information also.
Yes, global warming is creating a lot of problems to different countries and almost all the continents. And lately, I have heard that in Turkey is also facing a great problem because their seas are receding and people are really working towards that. Fishes are dying and it will be yes. creating a lot of problem for them. But I feel communities in the neighborhood should rise and teach or practice about eco-friendly products. And that is, I think, which is very, very essential to kind of adopt that kind of lifestyle. And I yes. think, and this lifestyle which we are talking today, I think when we talk about Indian culture or Indian tradition, it was long being practiced in India. But still, there are some pockets where people have forgotten to live an eco-friendly lifestyle. So I think that is one thing which is very, very essential. What do you say?
Yes, I totally agree. And I think the RWAs we have RWAs in every society, every colony. So they have a very important role to play. And at the grassroots level, the people should go out, reach out to everyone and make them aware about the traditional way of living, which we had in India, that was very eco-friendly way. So we can again restart those things. And it is very important. It's not that people are not aware about it. It's just that you have to give them a push again, make them realize the things which were happening 10, let's say 20 years, 30 years or 40 years back, they were pretty good. So these days we have all got into a comfort zone and we all want a certain kind of lifestyle and things to happen fast. So perhaps we have changed the lifestyle, we have got into some new things also. But then we have the time again to restart the things, and RWA should have these kind of sessions where they invite people, where they invite the senior citizens also, where they invite the families and young kids, and where there's always a healthy discussion, two-way discussions, people talking to each other and making them introduced to the old things also. The young kids, they're not aware about what was the use of earthen pots, how it was beneficial for our health to drink water from the earthen pot. Now you see everyone is drinking water right from the refrigerator. So it's like wastage of electricity also. So these are the things I think which should be made, can be done at RWA level, which is like working at the grassroots level. So every small group is definitely giving something positive to the society.
At this point, I also want to raise one thing, because I think these courses or this training should be given very early in the school. So that will also yes. make a change, I guess. What do you?
Absolutely. I do agree that there should be a curriculum in the school to young kids, to kids who are going to the school at the very young level, and they should be told about the environment, how to preserve the environment, how to restore the environment, and what things they should be doing and what things they should not be following in their daily lives, which is very important. You teach young kids and they further take these things back to home, back to their elders in the family. And in a way, they are giving back what they're learning from the school, giving back to the society. So it's a very good way to teach young kids about it. And it should be there in the school syllabus also.
You see that if we care about environment will care about us. Everybody will be happy. Sure. So it is so wonderful to talk to you, Ritu, and discuss few points which are very essential for a healthy lifestyle. So we'll be meeting again with next episode with the next great topic. Till then, bye-bye and take care.
Bye-bye. Stay safe and take care of yourself. Thank you.
Bye. We have some unique Akulmec memorabilia, which will make you look outstanding. The graphics on these corporate gifts are based on the global best business practices. To become recipient of one of these gifts for free, you have to watch this video till the end and provide your valuable comments, or you can also share your experiences. The person who makes the best comment would be chosen to become a recipient of this beautiful Akulmec gift, absolutely free, delivered to your doorsteps. The winner would also get a chance to be invited live as a distinguished panelist during our next video. What are you waiting for, friends? Please subscribe Akulmec and smash that like.